friend. He called him a rock star, Sally.
That's right, Michelle. Myron had a remarkable stint in the Steelers broadcast booth, 35 years, with only two play-by-play partners, the late Jack Fleming and then Bill Hillgrove. It was Billy's second turn with Myron, having worked here with him at WTAE-TV for years. A lot of history to which you say goodbye. It was a call that was expected, dreaded, and sad.
I thought of Myron, and I thought, you know, how would he want us to handle it? And he'd want us to celebrate, and that's what you have to do.
And for Billy Hillgrove, that celebration includes a special private memory of Myron at Conneaut Lake.
It was midnightish, and it was a big full harvest moon, and he's on the front of my boat, and I've got a great sound system, and I had Count Basie turned up just about all the way, and he's conducting the Count Basie Band. Never got a picture.
Billy says Myron saw the world through funny glasses.
He found humor in places that you and I would never look. And that was his secret. I mean, he could make a game that was boring and non-competitive and out of control seem interesting because he'd tell stories. And he was the greatest storyteller that I've ever been around.
Billy's description? Cope's calling card was a great mind.
He got into the cranium of people. And excuse me, Myron, for borrowing that line. But, you know, he knew what Pittsburghers wanted and Steelers fans. And, you know, I don't know if that act would have flown in other places. I hope I'm not discrediting Myron in any way. But he was Pittsburgh.
Myron played to the great passions of Pittsburgh, sports and the Steelers. But his great passion was his wife Mildred and his family. Billy remembers how devastated Myron was when Mildred died of cancer in 1994.
It rocked him. And that's when you get a true picture of Cope the human being, you know, family guy. That was more important than anything.
And that extended to the families of his friends.
Anytime we had a family crisis, in a sickness or illness or death or anything wrong with the family, he was the first one on the phone. Is there anything I can do? People who dwell amongst the yoys and double yoys and gargonzolas never got to see that side of Myron.
And you could say thank you. What would you thank him for?
I would thank him for having the courage to be himself. That's hard to do sometimes. Excuse me.
And Myron's proudest moment? Not the Super Bowls, not Sports Illustrated articles, not the Hall of Fame. Billy thinks it was when in 1996 he gave the terrible towel to Allegheny Valley School to help in the battle against autism and to enable thousands of deserving kids to have better lives. Michelle?